الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانا وأصحها بيانا فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الطريقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجليل وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. All Muslims, believers, this Shaaban is coming to middle of it. And we are expecting, inshallah, in front of us, Ramadan. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sha'ban wa shahrullah wa Ramadan wa shahri Rajab wa shahrullah wa Sha'ban wa shahri wa Ramadan wa shahru Ummah. This month, Rajab, that part, is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sha'ban is the month of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ramadan is the month of the Ummah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast a lot of Sha'ban. That Sayyida Aisha said one time, radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha, when she was asked about fasting of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Sha'ban, she said that I never saw Prophet fasting a month like he was fasting Sha'ban. She said that a month that he always seemed like going most of the month he was fasting of Sha'ban. The most fasted month by Prophet ﷺ after Ramadan was Sha'ban. Because it is his month. In that month, he is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness for his ummah. Why Prophet ﷺ has to fast Sha'ban? When he says Sha'ban is my month, means it is my property. Allah gave it to me. So I want to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I am a good servant to you, Ya Rabbi. I am fasting for you the whole month. Sometimes she used to say that she rarely see him breaking fast in Sha'ban. Because he wants to prepare the ummah. He wants to give the ummah from his ibadah, to share his ummah from his age, from his life. That's why it is said that when Prophet ﷺ was called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he was on the age 63. Allah sent Sayyidina Azra'il and Sayyidina Jibreel. And they said, Ya Rasulallah, Allah is sending you salam and giving you the right, the only person that have right to decide if he likes to die or not, if he likes to come to me or not. You want to stay, you stay. You want to come to Ar-Rafiq al-A'la, the highest companion, which translates in Arabic, means the divine presence in the presence of his Lord. You like, it's up to you. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Rabbi, it's better that I come to you. It's enough for me. Awliya Allah, they say that Allah gave Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam age of 137 years. But Prophet ﷺ decided that he go on 63 years because he wants to share the balance of 137 to 63, what is left, like 70 years. He wants to share it with his ummah as if he wants to give from his life a drop of his life to every person of his ummah. In order that in the day of judgment, all his ummah will come up with that light of Sayyidina Muhammad that he put from his life into them. Awliya Allah expressed a great happiness when that reality appears to them. That
doesn't appear to anyone. And this is what Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, said. And I heard it from him many times. He said, Allah opened a door for us to know the secret why Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left dunya at age of 63. He said, because he sacrificed his life for the benefit of the Ummah, to share with them his balance of his life for 137 years. So now, he said, Shahban Shahri means, in that month, Ya Rabbi, what you are giving me, I want to give to my Ummah. Rajab is month of Allah. What Allah gives to the Ummah, we don't know. But Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, in Rajab, he always hears, in all the year, Sarirul Aqlam in Arabic. When the pen writes, it gives sound. So when angels are writing what is good and what is bad from everyone is doing, from his sins and from his good deeds, Prophet hears that sound of the pen. He said, in month of Rajab, I don't hear sounds of pen. They stop. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the month of Allah. Allah doesn't want anyone to know what he will give his servant and what his servant is doing in that month. Even angels, they are not allowed to hear it. It is given only, and that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Rajab, I don't hear the writing of the pen. That is a good thing. That is a good thing to us. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closed the door of hell, open the door of heaven in month of Rajab. That's why many people, they say, they die in Rajab. Very well known. If anyone die in Rajab or Shaban or Ramadan, go to paradise. So Rajab or Shahrullah is the month of Allah. Shaban is the month of Prophet. So whatever he does, he wants to share with his Ummah. To prepare them for Ramadan. Because Ramadan is the month of the Ummah. And in Ramadan, what you are doing, it will add on what Allah gave you in Rajab, it will add what Prophet ﷺ requested for you in Sha'ban to be given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they prepare you and they chain. That's why Allah said, according to Prophet ﷺ hadith, that Allah said in Ramadan, Iblis will be chained. Devils will be chained. They cannot run after a fasting person. And that's why fasting is required in Ramadan. Many Muslims, unfortunately, today, they don't fast or they break fast for many reasons. They give you an answer when you ask them. They give you an answer they think they are giving you an excuse, but it is a bad excuse. But still, Allah's mercy is big. Why? Because the hadith of Prophet ﷺ said that when he asked, who is the muflis? Who is the bankrupted? Who is the poor? Well, the poor is the meaning, usual meaning for the poor or bankrupted, that he has no wealth, he has nothing. So he asked Sahaba, who is the poor? And they said, Ya Rasulullah, the poor is the one that has no money. And Prophet said, no. The poor is the one that has no amal. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, he's speaking to the Sahaba. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, he has no amal even if he is fasting, because they are fasting and they are praying. Even they are fasting and praying, he said, even they are fasting and praying, they have no amal. They will be bankrupted. And they asked Ya Rasulullah, why? He said, those who backbite, those who speak on the back of people, those who make confusion, fitna, those who make namima, they said, they spread rumors here and there, which is a wrong rumor. Might be you backbite, might backbite sometimes, it's a real event that happened, and you spread it. But namima is something that never happened, but you spread it
You spread a something and you make it to look normal and people believe it.
That's Naneem. Riba is different, Naneema is different, Fitna is different. Those three things, someone does them, is going to see that he has no amal, he will be bankrupt. But on the other hand, Allah said, وَمَا أَسْتَرْنَكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you mercies for the humanity. Ya Muhammad. So all of us, although with our weaknesses, with our bad amal, with our even backbiting, which all of us does it, or saying things which are not true, still Rahmatullah is big. Still Allah sent Prophet mercy for the humanity. So we would be saved with the Shafa'ah of Sayyidina Muhammad. Keep your love, as we said in the yesterday's speech. Keep your love to Sayyidina Muhammad. Keep your love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will save us. Mm-hmm. As it saved the Bedouin when he asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when is the day of the resurrection, judgment day? And he said, what you left for you that? What you prepared for that long travel? He said, Mahabbat, your love, Ya Rasulullah. He said, it's enough. May Allah forgive us. How we had our suffering. Li wa lakum wa lisa'il mustafirin fa yafawzan il mustafirin. Alhamdulillah, hamdal kamilin wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidina nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن قفيه فقال عز وجل مقائلا مخبرا عامرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مظهر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمسلمين الأحياء منهم والأموات واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم أجرنا من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب النار ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا كريم يا ستار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله تذكركم الله العظيم